Watch your head, Hunter.
Less than a week after parishioners were hauled off in handcuffs, a faithful fight continues despite locked church doors. WDSU News Channel 6 anchor Toslyn Alfonso is on your side with what's next for this Catholic community.
Even though church doors may be locked at both Our Lady of Good Counsel and St. Henry's Catholic Church, parishioners say they'll continue to hold prayer vigils outside the churches and fight for their Catholic community.
We plan to continue to say the rosary here every Sunday at 11 a.m. But we obviously, our goal still remains to get to the table and have a dialogue with the Archbishop. And we're still hopeful that the Archbishop will change his heart and meet with us.
This is just the beginning, sister, and I promise you this community will maintain its cohesiveness, its organizational capabilities, its communications capabilities, and its fundraising capabilities. And this pastoral plan is a trip in the desert. This pastoral plan has led us nowhere. This pastoral plan is dividing the body of Christ.
While the Archdiocese understands the decision to close the churches is painful, they say the closure is necessary because of storm damage, a diminished post-Katrina population, and a nationwide shortage of priests. All problems the faithful say they understand, but they wholeheartedly believe a compromise can be reached.
We agree with the Archbishop's plan to have a new parish created. All we're asking for is to be allowed to have one Mass a week here with our parishioners.
Meantime, the Archbishop says he has no regrets about the arrest this past week to remove parishioners from Our Lady of Good Counsel. A spokesperson for the Archdiocese says the Archbishop's decision is final and no compromises will be made. On your side, Toslyn Alfonso, WDSU, News Channel 6.
Church leaders from both St. Henry's and Our Lady of Good Counsel say they have filed civil suits in this matter.